Tonight, we celebrate the 40th anniversary of the John M. Huntsman Center at the University of Utah, the home of the Utes.
And the new arena, of course, is the talk of the basketball squad and the talk of the area. Tell us about it.
Bill, the new arena is going to seat 15,000 people, and it will be really the best arena, we think, for basketball in the United States.
An architectural wonder, the largest freestanding, column-free, wooden-supported dome in the world. The unique cloud is a mass of steel and concrete. It provides aesthetics, houses the lighting and sound and scoreboard, and actually holds the dome together and contributes to the great acoustics of the building. The opening act was comedian Bill Cosby. They heard him perfectly. Later, Pavarotti was overwhelmed with the sound. But it was first and foremost a place to showcase the Utes. The first game in the Special Events Center was on December 1st, 1969. Utah hosted Pac-10 opponent Stanford. The game was tied seven times down the stretch. Newland hit 23 of 25 foul shots, set a school record that still stands today. Utah opened the building with a win, 96-94. In the mid-80s, the name was changed to the John M. Huntsman Center to honor the international philanthropist for his contributions to Utah athletics. The greatest shots ever made in the Huntsman Center? Here's the scenario. Utah down by one, 1 second left to play, and they don't have the ball. Yet they win the game. The Wyoming player inbounds the ball by throwing it towards the Wyoming basket. No one touched it, so it goes out of bounds and comes back where he threw it. Utah has the ball now. 1 second left. Down by one. Manny Hendricks, a 22-footer. The greatest shot for the women came this year. Kaylee Whipple's three. Descended into a fourth overtime against TCU. Coach Fern Gardner started the women's winning tradition in the Huntsman Center. And Elaine Elliott has amplified it. With All-Americans like Debbie Asper, Julie Cromanhook, and Kim Smith, the women have won 88.7% of all their games in this building. The Huntsman Center has given the Utes one of the best home court advantages in the country. Playing on the Huntsman Center floor has been the dream of almost every high school basketball player in the state. Not only does it mean they're in the big dance, but they're also playing where some of the greatest in NCAA history have played. Talk about history. Ever since the first national title in 1981, this building has been the center of women's collegiate gymnastics. Utah has won a record 10 national titles, produced more All-Americans than any other school. The Huntsman Center has been the scene of 8 NCAA championships and 11 regionals, with another one coming up this year. In 2009, Utah again set the record for all women's collegiate sports by averaging 13,861 fans in the Huntsman Center for every home gymnastics meet. And this year, they broke their own single meet record when 15,552 fans turned out to see Utah beat Georgia. Coach Greg Marsden really knows how to put on a show, and the Huntsman Center really knows how to show it off. In 1979, it all came together. The perfect game in the perfect place. Magic in the Michigan State Spartans against Bird and the Indiana State Sycamores. It's been called the greatest NCAA ever. It was the most watched basketball game, college or pros, in the history of television. It was the night the world came to the Huntsman Center. And now Jim Boylan and his edition of Utah basketball has taken over occupancy. Boylan's style of play has put the running back in the running Utes. So here's to 40 more years of exciting games, history, and records in the John M. Huntsman Center. Happy anniversary!